Is it actually practical to go for a long ride on an EV? What all problems can be expected during the long ride on an EV bike ride?
Electric bikes in the market right now, at least the budget ones, they are meant for the casual city use. You can't expect comfort for longer ride on EVs like this.
Are there enough charging stations on the highway?
Practically, there are not many charging stations present for EV right now. There are very few. And the charging stations present right now are also not that good.
So with existing charging stations, how do I plan for a long ride? How do I plan it? The most important thing for a long ride on EV is of course the charging stations. So research well about the charging stations present right on your route for your long ride. If you have the fast chargers like this from Ather, or if you have the hypercharger of Ola, it's amazing. But if not this, then you'd have to depend on the third party charging stations like Bolt and Charger, which are merely 3-pin power sockets, so which means you have to carry your portable charger to charge your bike. Let's assume that you figured the charging station out and you plugged in your bike. Now what do? Because the charging takes time, no? Now, if you are plugged into your fast charger, it takes around 1 hour or something to charge your bike, so you can wait in a restaurant or cafe like this. What if you are plugged into a portable charger? It takes 4 hours or 5 hours. What do? You have to plan something for that time. Such a waste of time, right? That's the reality of having an EV. No matter how planned you are, range anxiety will always kick in while you're riding your EV. I have 3 tips that you can use which can help you to squeeze in more range from your bike. Always maintain a consistent speed while riding an EV. If you brake faster and if you accelerate faster, your battery will take a hit. So prefer not to do that. Always regenerate your battery while riding your EV. You'll add just 1 km or 2 km from your bike, but that will come handy when you're low on charge. And always don't prefer to ride at the maximum speed of your bike. Prefer a speed which is less than 60 or 70. That way, you won't put a lot of load on your bike to provide consistent power. First factor is the headwind. Open highways are known for heavy headwind and they are very bad for your range. Second factor is if you climb hill slopes, you will consume about 20% or 30% of more charge than usual. We have spoken about this in detail in this video. And if the total weight present on the bike is more than 150 kilos, even that will reduce the range of your bike. And in fact, the simplest thing is your tire pressure. If your tire pressure is lesser than what it should be, you will get 10% or 20% of lesser range than normal. A lot of factors to just kill the range of your bike. And hence, those tricks that I previously mentioned are very important. In spite of all these, there are a few practical problems which will trouble your long ride. Sitting posture. You see, these bikes are actually scooties and they are not meant for long rides. You might feel uncomfortable with the sitting posture. And second factor is waste of time. You see, it takes a lot of time to charge your bike. Such a waste of time. And third factor is of course the range anxiety. You have to constantly think about the range anxiety, which will just trouble you all the way. And the fourth factor is the sunlight readability of the dashboard. Yes, you have a dashboard and yes, you have a dashboard navigation, but the sunlight readability is not that good. So you might want to look for shadows whenever you want to look at the navigation while you're on your ride or long ride. Now, having said all these, I have had amazing rides on my second generation of 450X Ather. Long rides, I mean. The first one was, of course, my ride in Nandi Hills, which was extremely adventurous because of the range anxiety. You see, there was one situation where I had to ride 35 kilometers to reach for the nearest charger, but I had only a range of 19 kilometers. Believe it or not, we ended up reaching there with 2 kilometers to spare. Wanna know how I did that? There's a full video on that. Second situation was inside the city as well, where I had to ride about 11 kilometers to reach the nearest charger. The range that I had left was also 11 kilometers, but I reached the spot with 5 kilometers to spare. There is a video on that as well. All the tricks that I explained to you right now and having a knowledge about the factors that affect the range of your bike can help you a long way while on your long ride on your Ather 450X. Now, having said all these, do I still recommend you guys to go for a long ride on your 450X Ather? Absolutely yes. As of 2023, the ride on your bike can be a bit adventurous, but once more charging stations are in place, you'd love your ride on your EV. So, have you guys tried long ride on your 450X Ather? I'm on my way to mine. Please do let us know your experience in the comments below.